Mahatme ji.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Sir, I shall like to congratulate the government as well as Honorable Health Minister for bringing this bill. Actually, this bill was brought in 2016, but then the Lok Sabha time was lapsed, and then afterwards, actually in between, it was sent to standing committee also. So now it was introduced in Lok Sabha and it has been passed in Lok Sabha. Now it has come to Rajya Sabha. Sir, I was the member of standing committee under the chairmanship of Honorable Ram Gopal Yadav ji, and we discussed this issue at length, and I feel proud that I was member of that committee, or this committee. And most of the recommendations were accepted in this bill. Sir, previously, this surrogacy was unregulated for so many years, 15 years. Lekin us waqt sarkar ne, us waqt jo sarkar thi, usne koi kadam nahi uthaya. Law Commission ka 228 ka jo report hai, usme bhi kaha gaya tha ki ye jo surrogacy ho rahi hai, illegal surrogacy jo practices ho rahe hain aur usme exploitation ho raha hai, isliye iske liye कानून बनाया जाए, ये अगस्त 2009 की बात है सर. लेकिन उसके ऊपर कोई कानून उस वक्त लाया गया नहीं. लेकिन ये मोदी सरकार है जो प्रोएक्टिवली काम करती है, और ये ऑनरेबल हेल्थ मिनिस्टर ने ये बिल लाया है, इसलिए मैं उनका अभिनंदन करता हूँ. क्योंकि प्रीवियस गवर्नमेंट ने काफ़ी बार ऐसा, काफ़ी बार होता है कि हम सरकार में काफ़ी कर्मचारी लोग ऐसा बोलते हैं कि काम कुछ करो मत, यानी कोई टोकता नहीं है, कोई बोलता नहीं है कि काम अच्छा नहीं हुआ या ऐसा नहीं किया, करना था वैसा करना था. लेकिन इस सरकार ने वक्त पे, समय पर बिल लाया और उसका फॉलोअप किया, उसको डिस्कशन के लिए कमिटी की तरफ भी भेजा स्टैंडिंग, और अभी फिर से राज्यसभा में लाया. इसलिए मैं उनको कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन देना चाहूँगा. सर, what was the necessity of this bill? The most important was that illegal and surrogacy was going on, and there was exploitation of poor surrogate mother, which because of want of money, they used to have two or three surrogacy or pregnancy for the want of money, and they were exploited. They were not aware about what were the problems of this surrogacy or the pregnancy also. If you think of the diabetes, hypertension, or ये जो long term problems रहते हैं कभी कभी pregnancy में, वो उनके बारे में उनको जानकारी भी नहीं रहती थी, क्योंकि वो illiterate और poor class के लोग रहते थे जो surrogate mother होते थे. अब because of this bill, now this will be prohibited, and the thing is that the this surrogate mothers will not be exploited because of this bill. Secondly, there used to be a risk of life during pregnancy, and that risk will be covered by this bill. Somebody said that the medicines, etc., who will pay for that medicine and insurance? But actually, in the bill, there is a provision for 16 months, the insurance will be covered, and the medical expenses will be borne by the intending couple. So there is a protection to the surrogate mother. So I feel I welcome this bill. Secondly, if the child born out of surrogacy, if the child is born and the child is physically challenged or is not developed well, or the intending couple wanted some one gender and that gender, the baby is not of that gender, then they will used to be getting abandoned that child, and this used to happen many times, and that's why this bill has been brought, and now this will not happen, and they will have to take that baby as a biological child of the intending couple. So that is very important, and we must understand that this bill was very much necessary, and it has been brought in time. इसके पहले जो बिल आया था उसमें एक कहा था कि the intending couple should have a certificate of infertility, but now in this bill, because it was difficult to have an infertility certificate for gynecologists and obstetricians. It was very difficult to define infertility and tell to the couple that you are infertile. Because many times we also know that 5 years, 10 years of infertility, and then they suddenly get the pregnancy. So it was very difficult, and now it has been improved as per the standing committee recommendation that the intending couple will need the infertility the certificate of essentiality and eligibility. So this change is welcome and was much necessary, and that has been incorporated in the bill. There is a provision for National Surrogacy Board as well as the State Surrogacy Board, and those will be established, and they will formulate the regulations. These regulations will be according to the state regulations, will be according to the need of that state. So there will be a flexibility in the rules as per the requirement of the state. And thirdly, the close relatives definition can also be regulated by this National Surrogacy Board. So I think that will be taken care of. The assisted reproductive technology, which is required before surrogacy. So I think the 5 years which are required, then only the intending couple can become can apply for surrogacy. Is very much necessary, because they have to undergo first this assisted reproductive technology. They should use this assisted reproductive technology, and if it fails, then only they should go for surrogacy. So that means 5 years period is also okay and is necessary, so that they can avail this surrogacy facility. Today, as per Ram Gopal ji, they also informed that the egg or the female oocyte is sold, and is sold at 6 lakhs, what he told yesterday. And this will not be possible once this bill is passed in this Rajya Sabha. So I welcome this move, because the illegal ways of doing all this surrogacy, selling of ovum or the egg was continuously happening, and now it will stop, and this is a great necessity, and that will be fulfilled by this bill. Is bill mein ye bhi hai ki jo National Surrogacy Board banega usme experts rahenge, jo ki khud gynecologists, obstetricians, NGOs, jo citizen forum ke log hain, to isme sabhi logon ke inputs rahenge, aur us inputs ke wajah se जो भी रूल्स रेगुलेशंस बनेंगे वो बहुत ही स्टैंडर्ड के बनेंगे, और उसमें सभी के व्यूज आएंगे. तो मुझे लगता है ये अच्छा तरीका है रेगुलराइज करने का, ताकि उसमें कुछ चेंजेस यदि करने हैं तो वो जल्दी हो सकते हैं. आपको भी सबको पता है कि हर बार बिल पार्लियामेंट ले लाना यानी 2-3 साल चले जाते हैं, तो इसलिए ये बहुत अच्छा है कि नेशनल सरोगेसी बोर्ड बन रहा है, और उसमें सभी एक्सपर्ट्स भी रहने वाले हैं और सभी सिटीजन फोरम के लोग भी रहेंगे. देयर वाज अ थिंग दैट द ट्रांसजेंडर और अ सिंगल पेरेंट और सिंगल पर्सन वांट्स टू अंडरगो द सरोगेसी एंड गेट द चाइल्ड, बट देयर इज अनदर ऑप्शन. We should also think of a transgender person wants to be a father or mother, then they can be, because there is an option of adoption is also there, and they can avail those options. So I don't think that we are discriminating in that way. So adoption is also a good option available for this. So in brief, I shall like to tell that ki bhai hamare samaj mein ek hum rudivadi hai. जब भी शादी होती है तो उसके बाद में सबको ऐसा लगता है, सब पेरेंट्स को, सब कपल्स को ऐसा लगता है कि जल्दी ही बच्चा हो, और घर के लोग भी उसके ऊपर दबाव डालते हैं. तो उस वक्त यदि बच्चा नहीं होता है तो उसके लिए एक अच्छा अल्टरनेटिव है, और इस बिल से ये अल्टरनेटिव सरोगेसी से वह माँ बाप बन सकते हैं, और ये बड़ी खुशी की बात है उनके लिए भी, और ये हमारे लिए भी, क्योंकि इसमें दूसरे जो सरोगेट मदर बन रही है उनके लिए भी बहुत अच्छी बात है और खुशी की बात है कि वो किसी के लिए अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, किसी को माँ बाप बनाने में अपना काम कर रही है और वो कोई कमर्शियल इंटरेस्ट रख के नहीं, परोपकारी भावना से कर रही है, तो उसको भी बहुत अच्छा लगेगा और बहुत खुशी होगी। मुझे लगता है हम सब खुश होकर खुशी से ये बिल पास करें ताकि सभी लोग माँ पिताजी बनने के लिए जो भी खुशी चाहते हैं उनको हम वो खुशी दे सकें। धन्यवाद सर।